بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to the third day of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us our fasting, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honor us by worshipping Him the way that pleases Him. Allahumma ameen. The verses today are selected from the third juz of the Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 257, 258 and 259. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الله ولي الذين آمنوا يخرجهم من الظلمات إلى النور والذين كفروا أولياءهم الطاغوت يخرجونهم من النور إلى الظلمات أولئك أصحاب النار هم فيها خالدون ألم تر إلى الذي حاج إبراهيم في ربه أن آتاه الله الملك إذ قال إبراهيم ربي الذي يحيي ويميت قال أنا أحيي وأميت قال إبراهيم فإن الله يأتي بالشمس من المشرق فأت بها من المغرب فبهت الذي كفر والله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين أو كالذي مر على قرية وهي خاوية على عروشها قال أنى يحيي هذه الله بعد موتها فأماته الله 100 عام ثم بعثه قال كم لبثت قال لبثت يوما أو بعض يوم قال بل لبثت 100 عام فانظر إلى طعامك وشرابك لم يتسنه وانظر إلى حمارك ولنجعلك آية للناس وانظر إلى العظام كيف ننشزها ثم نكسوها لحما فلما تبين له قال أعلم أن الله على كل شيء قدير. When you look at the first verse, الله ولي الذين آمنوا, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, He is the helper of those who believed. He is the one who takes them out from darkness to the light. While الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَوْلِيَاؤُهُمُ الطَّاغُوتِ, the helpers of the disbelievers are الطَّاغُوتِ. الطَّاغُوتِ, whatever you worship beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is considered طَاغُوتِ. Regardless, it is a desire or wealth or a statue or whatever. They drive them out from light to darkness. And Allah mentioned, أُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ, they are the companions of hellfire. هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ, they will reside in forever. As you see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the similarity of iman the similarity of light. And He equalized between disbelief and darkness. With the iman, you figure out from where did you come and what are we supposed to do and to where should be your destination. But when you live in darkness, you cannot figure out or observe what you need to observe. Then the verse after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about Ibrahim alayhi salam and his debate with An-Numrud ibn Kan'an, the king, the tyrant of his time. So they were in debate about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. آتَاهُ اللَّهُ الْمُلْكِ Allah gave him the kingdom. Can be applied to Ibrahim, can be applied to Al-Numrud ibn Kan'an as well. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah آتَاهُ الْحُكْمَ وَالْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon Ibrahim the book and the wisdom, which is a part of his prophethood. As when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted An-Numrud ibn Kan'an as a trial for him, being the ruler for his people, whom he abused this authority and this power. إِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ رَبِّيَ الَّذِي يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتُ Ibrahim mentioned that my Lord is the one who gives life and the one who takes life away. And it seems like it is an answer of a question. Like the Pharaoh asked Musa, وَمَنْ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ Then Ibrahim answered An-Numrud, my Lord is the one who gives life and the one who takes it away. And when you talk about giving life and taking it away, the one who can give life, survive the dead, and take it away with a reason or without a reason. Then An-Numrud, he said, قَالَ أَنَا أُحْيِي وَأُمِيتُ I can do such thing. Then Ibrahim alayhi salam, as a prophet of Allah, he doesn't want to waste his time debating in such argument. He mentioned to him, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْتِي بِالشَّمْسِ مِنَ الْمَشْرِقِ Ibrahim alayhi salam, he said to him, addressed him, My Lord, make the sunrise comes from the east. Can you bring the sunrise from the west? فَبُهِتَ الَّذِي كَفَرْ He, An-Numrud ibn Kan'an, became overwhelmed in astonishment. He cannot do anything, he cannot say anything. وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ And Allah does not lead to the straight path the unfair doors. Then the verse after this talked about a man who passed by a ruined village. Then he was wondering, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to return this place or these people back to life? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala afflicted him with death for 100 years. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala returned him back to life. ثُمَّ بَعَثَ Then Allah asked him, Do you know for how long you were dead? He said, For a day or a part of a day. Then Allah the Almighty mentioned to him, You were dead for 100 years. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him to look at his food and his drink. لَمْ يَتَسَنَّ There is nothing wrong happened to them. As if these 100 years didn't pass over it. Still warm, still clean. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him to look at his donkey. Then it is dead. And the remaining bones of the donkey beside him. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed him how to survive the donkey back. How to return the donkey back to life. The bones had been gathered, covered with the flesh, and here all of a sudden the donkey back to life. Then the comment was, قَالَ أَعْلَمُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ I know that my Lord omnipotent. Allah has infinite power. He can do whatever he wants. So out of the first story of An-Numrud ibn Kan'an, it is an evidence and proof that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator, can do everything. And within the story of the man who passed by the village, maybe doubting the capability of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he will return things back and denying the resurrection or have doubts about the resurrection, this is a proof that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will return us back to life. Allah the Almighty stated, مَا خَلْقُكُمْ وَلَا بَعْثُكُمْ إِلَّا كَنَفْسٍ وَاحِدًا. Your creation and your returning back to life for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is as costive as only one soul being created and being returned back to life. كَيْفَ تَكْفُرُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَكُنْتُمْ أَمْوَاتًا فَأَحْيَاكُمْ ثُمَّ يُمِيتُكُمْ ثُمَّ يُحْيِيكُمْ ثُمَّ إِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. How come you disbelieve in Allah while you were dead, and He is the one who grants you life, and He will be the one who afflict you with death, and He will be the one to whom you will be returned? Jazakumullahu khayran wa ghafarallahu li wa lakum. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.